I'm Dale Denardo. I am an associate professor in the School of Life Sciences at Arizona State University. Arizona is well known for the diversity of snakes that we have, because in deserts, snakes do very well because they can go long times without eating. We have probably 35, 40 species of snakes in general, but we have 19 different types of rattlesnakes. So we have the greatest diversity of rattlesnakes anywhere in the world. There's a good chance of seeing rattlesnakes certain times of year, and that's where it's warm enough, the animals come out, but not too hot. When it gets too hot, they move to being nocturnal. And the thing to remember is they're not out to get anybody. They want to be left alone. The best thing to do if you see a rattlesnake is, one, is appreciate it. It is part of our natural environment, and they serve a role in that environment. If you're there, if you see it, back away. Don't try and scare it away. Don't try to do anything. Just trying to separate you from the encounter. One of the deals about getting bit by a rattlesnake is there's not instant pain. There's not instant changes in swelling. So a lot of people think, oh, I got bit, but it's not a big deal. Never assume, don't wait it out. Assume that it's a bad bite and that you need to get medical attention. And the first thing they'll do is put you on fluids, because rattlesnake bites tend to cause peripheral vasodilation, or dilation of your vessels, and therefore your blood pressure crashes. They'll also monitor your potential use of antivenom, and usually they will give people antivenom. And once you're in the hospital, you're in pretty good hands. So the big thing is getting there quickly, but not doing it in a panic. The bite is very rarely fatal. Some of the myths about treating rattlesnake bite in the field when you first get bit involve cutting between the fangs marks and sucking it out. That just causes an additional injury, potential infection, because that venom quickly dissipates through the tissue, so you're not really going to pull out much venom. Other things is to apply a tourniquet. That doesn't work very well. One is you cause additional damage to your arm. Two is most of the rattlesnake damage, even though it also has systemic effects, also has a lot of local effects, a lot of necrosis. And don't do anything except get yourself medical attention. If they wanted to bite something, they don't rattle their tail. When they see a mouse and want to eat it, they don't rattle their tail. So when they're rattling, that means they're doing you a favor. They're telling you, go away, I don't want this confrontation. And it's only if you continue to pursue that and actually get to approach, they'll strike. In all environments, you want a balance. You want preys, you want first level predators, secondary level predators. And in deserts, we don't have a lot of large predators. Rattlesnakes are the number one predator out there. And so in order to balance the rodent population, these rattlesnakes play a very important role in our ecosystem. And so we need to understand that. If they're out there, you're in their world if you're going for a hike, if you're wandering, and their world is one that's balanced. So the best thing is keep the distance. And another important thing is appreciate the experience that you're getting. These are very important components of our natural system. They're interesting to watch. Like I said, it's a harmless interaction as long as you keep your distance.